In 2012, America's on-again, off-again love affair with Formula One finally seemed to settle down with the completion of this wonderful racing facility here in Texas. Since then, we've been treated to some incredible races, including, of course, that classic wet-dry championship decider of 2015. We're racing today, then, in Travis County, Texas, where 20 corners and speeds of up to 200 miles an hour await us on this magnificent racetrack. It's 60% full throttle with plenty of good opportunities to pass, especially through the two DRS zones into Turn 1 and at the end of the long back straight into Turn 12. What a race we have in store today. With me today is Anthony Davidson, a man who knows this circuit quite well. Why do you think, though, Ants, that this Grand Prix has now found such huge success since returning to the calendar in 2012?
Well, full credit to the race promoters. They have a Grand Prix in a part of the country famed for its love of motorsport, and they do a fantastic job of advertising it to the right crowd, and then satisfying them when they're here with excellent facilities. It also tends to help when the circuit itself is good, and that's definitely true here. The layout is interesting, and it produces some exciting action. Hosting a thrilling title decider like we had in 2015 wouldn't hurt either, so the pressure's on then to maintain that kind of quality here today.
Okay, you can brake late into one because of the incline. It's a slow corner though, so make sure you stay out of trouble. Good luck.
So before the off, let's remind ourselves of yesterday's qualifying session with a look at the starting grid. Nico Rosberg is on pole position today after coming out on top of a difficult qualifying. And it's Lewis Hamilton alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Ricciardo, Raikkonen, Max Verstappen, and Vettel, Bottas, Button, Alonso, and Sergio Perez. Massa, Hülkenberg, Romain Grosjean, and Sainz, Kvyat, Gutierrez, Pascal Wehrlein, and Kevin Magnussen, Palmer, and Ericsson, Rio Haryanto, and Felipe Nasser starts from the back of the grid. Now it's almost time to lights out, so let's go down to the track.
Magnussen. They've got a serious car issue. It looks like they're retiring.
Strategy.
seconds. has just taken the lead.
So another fantastic victory for the Silver Arrows. Anthony, what do you think made the difference here?
Oh, I'd say it's just raw pace, plain and simple. I mean, we could sit here and talk about strategy all day, the overtaking, looking after the tyres, but at the end of it all, if you want to win, you need a package that's got the speed over everyone else, and that's exactly what they had today.
So as I say that, we can see the drivers coming out now to collect their trophies. It's yet more silverware to take back to their base in Brackley after another excellent Grand Prix. And now let's take a look at the driver standings. It wasn't the best weekend for our championship leader, and their advantage at the top has been reduced. Moving on to the driver of the day then. Anthony Davidson, who would you go for?
Felipe Massa. For me, that was an outstanding performance that drew on every bit of his not unsubstantial experience.
And here's how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. The lead at the top comes down after a strong weekend from the challenging pack. There'll be plenty more twists and turns to come this season. I hope you can join us at the next race to see just who will come out on top.